How's it going there, boy? Welcome back to my channel. Sandy, owner driver of SJM here. Right, today's video is a question I've been getting asked, or a bit of advice. Now, it's not about costing or that for the now, because that is going to take me a wee while to kind of make a video for that. But what this one is my mate contacted me the other day, and it is a frequently asked question of concern. What people on the road worried about the risk, right? Going to go into this straight away, there's always going to be risk. You can't avoid the risk, but you can minimise the risk, okay? And this is what I said to him would be my advice to do. I mean, yes, I went out, bought my lorry, painted my colours, did it the way I wanted to do it, but that was my choice. If you are a bit nervous and concerned about, you know, going out there and worried about losing money, here's maybe just to minimise the risk for yourself, okay? And this is my advice on the situation. It's my personal opinion and my advice. You don't have to take it, but just give you an idea. So, say for example, you're driving for someone right now, you want to go out on your own, that's your decision. Go and get your operator's license sorted, right? Go get a bank account, okay? Put the money in you need for the operator's license, which for the first lorry will be £7,850, okay? I would always recommend to put in more though, because it looks a wee bit better for the application. If you just put in the exact figure, it doesn't, you know what I mean? Just put in a bit more, try and put 10,000 in, or as much as you can. Right, the money's not going to go away there, it's a sole trader, just stick it in the account, you can take it back out when you want if you change your mind, right? Anyway, stick the money in the account, get your operator's license sorted, get everything ready to go, okay? So you're all set to go, bar you do not have a lorry, okay? So you can be driving the truck you're working in right now, and you have your own operator's license ready to go, you just need to buy the lorry, okay? And the reason I say this is because somebody can come up to you and offer you work and you go, I don't bother, but you can't start for 3 or 4 months. But the work needs to start next week. Okay, and that's it, you can't do it. But if everything's ready to go, okay, see what I'm saying? You would just be right, no bother, I can start in a week or 2 weeks, however you see fit. And then this is the bit, go and hire the lorry. There's some cracking deals out there for hiring trucks, okay? I mean, I've seen like, you know, lorries for about, you know, between 250, 350, depending on what work you're doing. Let's just say it's general haulage, either refrigerated work or curtain sider work. Lorry, 250 quid. Trailer, 150 quid for the week. In fact, let's just say 300 quid for the lorry, because hopefully you'll get a deal with maintenance involved in that as well and breakdown. So if it goes wrong, you know, it's there. They need to sort it out for you. And you know, I mean, 550 quid, 600 quid, 600, let's just say 600 quid as a whole, that is what you're paying a week for your unit and trailer, and, you know, breakdowns and maintenance are covered in your weekly inspection, 6 week inspection, okay? And then you're not making a full commitment on finance and, you know, monthly payments, etc. like that. It's if it doesn't work out for you, you can hand it back, right? You can just say, I've given it a go, I've dipped my toes, I've seen what it's like, I don't like it, or I do like it, and after 3 months of doing at it, or 6 months, however long you decide to take the term over, right, or how long you're going to go at this for, and then you decide, right, no, actually, this is working, I really am enjoying it, I want to go buy my own lorry, then go buy your own lorry, then decide what you're going to go do. That is a safer option, okay? That you know, like I said, can't completely annihilate risk, but you can minimize risk, okay? And this is just my opinion, remember. So break it down, get your CPC or an external transport manager, but I always recommend for you just do your own CPC. I think it's great to have it, it's great knowledge to have. This book I've got here, you know, great thing to have, and it's a great, you know, if you decide you don't want to work for yourself, you can go into an office and work your way up to being a transport manager for someone else and earn a better living for yourself. But like I said, get your own CPC or external transport manager, get the account open, money in, apply for the operator's license, have it all ready to go, and when the work does come on, whether it's subcontracted or direct, if you're lucky enough, and you've got your business plan in place, your figures, how long you need to work out to run, all your, as it says, pay for the lorry, the trailer, the fuel, and that's it. Depending if you want to take a wage for the first wee while, that's up to yourself. I didn't, but that was my choice because of the way I wanted to get the money back in the bank. And I had the options to sort of do that. Get it all in place, ready to go, right? Minimize the risk. Don't have to throw yourself all out there. You can just dip your toes in, okay? But if you like this video, give it a like, subscribe, comment below if the any other questions, I'll try and answer them. And like I said, I'll try and get more videos up as I can, but this is a third party thing amongst everything else I'm doing. But I do enjoy doing them and getting, you know, helping people out and giving advice. But in the meantime, stay safe, flat out, flat broke. Oosht.